فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
What's the ruling of the narration of a majhul al-dhat? لا تقبل, it's not accepted. الرواية majhul al-dhat, the narration of the majhul al-dhat, حتى يصرح الراوي عنه باسمه, until the name of the narrator is mentioned, or his name is brought to us. عراقي said, ومبهم التعديل ليس يكتفي به الخطيب والفقيه الصيرفي. The second type is what? مجهول العين. مجهول العين. What is مجهول العين? هو الراوي, it is the narrator. الذي ذكر اسمه, his name is mentioned. وعرفت ذاته. And the people know him as an individual. They know him. As in like, if somebody asked us, where's Yasser? It's like, there he is. Okay? لكن مقل في الحديث. But he's little in narration. فلا يكثر الأخذ عنه. فلا يكثر الأخذ عنه فلم يروي عنه إلا راو واحدا. Only one person came and narrated from him. He's little in his narration. Only one narrator narrated from him. That one is called مجهول العين. Now some of you may ask yourselves, why is it called مجهول العين when there's already one person who knows him? Just because it's just a مجرد الاصطلاح. It's just a terminology that the muhadithin want to use. What is the ruling regarding the مجهول العين? Okay, the other one who wasn't even known, who is he? Huh? Who's this person? Never heard of this person. The second one is, oh, Yasser. Who? How is he? Like, no, nobody, people know you, as in like they can point their finger at you. They one person narrated for you. Fakat, your narrations. That's all it is. That's what is the ruling regarding this hadith. اختلف العلماء, the scholars have a disagreement. في رواية مجهول العين, the narration of a مجهول العين, من حيث قبوله أو ردها, in terms of its acceptance or rejection. And there are views. There are views. The most important ones are these three. Sorry, these five. One, أنه لا يقبل مطلقا, that it's not accepted at all under any circumstances. And this is the view of the majority of the scholars of hadith. The second one is what? أنه يقبل مطلقا, that is accepted without an exception. It's accepted. And the scholars that took that is the scholars who conditioned, who said, قول من لم يشترط. It is the people who took that the مجهول العين is accepted without any problem, without any conditions. They are the ones who, the scholars, they say, وهو من لم يشترط في الراوي غير الإسلامي. They say the only condition we needed was Islam. Is he a Muslim? خلاص. And Nawawi رحمه الله, he said, a lot of people have this view, he said. But it's not the most. Number three, التفصيل. It needs conditions. Tafsil means it has to be explained. It can't, not.
Has to be looked into.
Yeah, so it can't be just yes, fully, like the first group, or no, not without exception. Nah, this is with tafsil, with the following. فَإِنْ كَانَ الرَّاوِي, with these conditions. فَإِنْ كَانَ الرَّاوِي, if the narrator, الْمُتَفَرِّدُ بِالرِّوَايَةِ, if this narrator who is singular in this narration, عَنْهُ, of him, if there's a person singular in narrating from him, لَا يَرْوِي إِلَّا عَدْلٍ مِثْلٍ. So مجهول العين, we said, is what? A person, only one person narrated from him, right? Are you guys with me?
Yes.
If this person who narrated from him, are you guys with me?
Yeah.
That person who narrated, so this person is not known. He's only known because this person narrated from him. If the person who narrated from him doesn't narrate from except people of Adil, people who are reliable, such as he narrates from Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, Malik ibn Anas, and the likes of them, قبيلة, it's accepted. وإلا فلا, and if not, if he doesn't do that, no, it's not accepted. That's the one, that's the group that done that tafsil. The fourth, they made another tafsil. They said, no, our one is this conditions. They said, فإن كان مشهورا في غير العلم, if this person is known for other knowledge, he's famous in other things, such as, for example, he's مشهور بالزهد, He's an aesthetic person. Such as who? Malik ibn Dinar. Or other than that. Or Najdata. فَإِنَّهُ يُقْبَلْ وَإِلَّا فَلَا. It's accepted, they said. فَإِنْ كَانَ مَشْهُورًا فِي غَيْرِ الْعِلْمِ. If he's famous for other knowledge, he's famous for that. Such as who? He's famous for zuhd, such as Malik ibn Dinar. فَإِنَّهُ يُقْبَلْ. Then his narration is accepted. وَإِلَّا فَلَا. And if not, no. So he's famous in something else. He might not be famous in the hadith, but they know him in the field of ibadah. Yeah. So okay, he's known in this one. So Ibn Abdul Barr, he took that view. He said he's accepted. The fifth one is, and inshallah I hope this one is the strongest one. It's the strongest one. Is what, and it is, in zakah wa a'immatul jarh wa ta'dil. If the scholars of jarh wa ta'dil praise him, ma'a riwayatan wahidan anhu, even if one narrates from him. So if the scholars of hadith accept him, are you guys with me? They praise him. Even that the only one person narrated from him. Even that though, one person narrated from him. It will be accepted. If not, no. If they didn't praise him, then no. And this is the choice of Abul Hassan ibn Qattan, and also Ibn Hajar took this view, and maybe this is the strongest one, and the just one, the middle path. So the matter goes back to the scholars of hadith. Goes back to the knowledge scholars of hadith. The third type, of majhul is what? Majhulul hal. Majhulul hal. It's called majhulul hal. What's majhulul hal? Majhulul hal, you can tell from the name, is that huwa man urifat. Huwa man urifat. Aynuhu. It is a person who he as an individual is known. Aynu. How can we say he is individually known? Two people have narrated from him. Bi riwayat ithnayn, two people narrated from him. But still, وَلَمْ يُوَثَّقْ. Nobody praised him like him. Two people narrated from him, but nobody praised him. And no one criticized him. Nobody criticized him, and no one praised him. And the مَجْهُولُ hal is two types. مَجْهُولُ It is a مَجْهُولُ hal, a person who is مَجْهُولُ hal. The first type is majhulul adala. He's unknown, but his adala is zahir and batin, internally and externally. And the second one is he's majhul and his adala is batin internally, but outside he's not. And this is what they call al masturul hal. Masturul hal. What's the view? The first type. We'll explain it, inshallah. The first type, which is the one who is majhulul adala, zahiran wa batinan. Sorry, brothers. What did I say? He's majhul, he's unknown. His adala is known, unknown internally and externally. Both are unknown. Are you with me? And the second one is majhulul adalati batinan. La zahiran. Outside, his adala outside is unknown. Are you with me? مجهول العدالة باطنا. He's unknown internally, but externally he's known. He doesn't have. So he's not unknown outside. Pay attention. His عدالة, the first type is what? His عدالة internally and externally is unknown. What is this man? What does he believe inside? What does he have in his heart? Nobody knows. Also, his outer appearance, the way he prays, whether he fasts, nobody knows. Nobody knows anything in or out from his situation. From his situation. Hala means situation. They know him as an individual. Two people have narrated from him. If one person narrates from him, what does he become? Machul al-ayn. He's past machul al-ayn. He's got two people narrating from him. Are you with me? He's now machul al-hal. But then his hal, his adala, internal and external is unknown. This, what is it? That's one. The second one is majhulul adalati batinan. Internally he's known. He's unknown, sorry. But like in la zahiran, outside no. And this is mastur. We're going to explain. Scholars, they disputed how does the narration of the majhul is taken. The first one, so because there are two types, the majhulul hal is two types. Majhulul adalati zahiran wa batinan. المجهول العدالة باطنا لا ظاهرا. So the first type, which is ظاهرا باطن, is what the one we're going to take. What is the, what's the ruling taking that narration, the first type? The scholars have disputed. اختلف العلماء في رواية من عرفت عينه وجهلت عدالته ظاهرا وباطنا. The scholars disputed each other. This person is known personally, he's known, but his situation is not known. No, whether he's reliable internally and externally, he's not known. Meaning they don't know his belief. And they don't know him from outside. There are views. There are three views regarding him. The jumhur of the scholars are of the view of what? لا تقبل. And the riwayat لا تقبل. His narration are not accepted. Because why? Because the condition of authenticity is what? That the adala is there, right? That the adala is there. But the adala isn't known. لأن التحقق العدالة شرط في قبول الرواية. It's a condition for the narration to be accepted. And this type, لم يتحقق. It's not become clear. لم تتحقق فيه العدالة. The adala has not become apparent to us. Okay? And Ibn Muwaq, he ascribed this to the muhaqqiqin. That's the view of the Jumhur. The second one is, يرى بعض العلماء قبول رواية معللا قوله. Some of the scholars, they see that his narration is accepted. روايته معللا, with a defect. With the reasoning and the reason in which they both is what? They said that he personally is known. Whether his adala needs to be known is not real. We could be sufficed. We don't really need to know his adala. We don't need to know his adala. The third one they said, وَيَرَى آخَرُونَ. Another group they see, التفصيل. It's التفصيل. Which is, فَإِنْ كَانَ الرَّاوِيَانِ. If the two narrators, أو الرواد, or the narrators, the number of narrators, who narrated it from him, مَنْ لَا يَرْوِي إِلَّا عَدْلٍ. Who do not narrate except, because two people narrated from him, right? He's got two. If those two people who narrated from him do not narrate from except people who are adal, they only narrate from people who are reliable, قُبِلَ, it's accepted, وَإِلَّا فَلَا. And if not, then no, his narration is rejected. The strongest, inshaAllah ta'ala, is the first, the Jumhur's belief. مَا ذَهَبَ إِلَيْهِ الْجُمْهُرُ لِقُوَّةِ دَلِيلِهِمْ. Because they have a more stronger evidence, which is that his narration is not accepted. The second type, which is what? It is the individual who عُرِفَتْ عَيْنُهُ, we know him, he's ma'roof, his عَيْن is known. وَعُرِفَتْ عَدَالَتُهُ, and his adala is known, ظَاهِرَة, from the outside. وَجُهِلَتْ عَدَالَتُهُ بَاطِنَة, but his adala inside, we're ignorant about it. And this is what the ulama know as what? Al-mastur. Masturu is what they know as. According to some scholars, there's two views regarding him, if these narrations are going to be accepted. The first qawl, or the first view, is the Jumhur's belief. The Jumhur is the majority of scholars. They see أن riwayatun mardudatun, that his narration is rejected. ما لم تثبت عدالته, as long as the adala is not clear. They said that we need to know it. And they said مستدلين بأن الفسق يمنع القبول, because they said that the fisq refuses for us not to, for acceptance. Because if his adala inside is not known, then fasiq, he can be from inside, and a fasiq, his narration to be accepted is far fetched. We can't do that. And they use the ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا. The second view is what? The second view. يرى جماعة من العلماء, a group of scholars saw, أن رواية المستور, that the riwayah of this one, which is مستور, مقبولة, it is accepted. And this is the قول of the حنفية and Ibn Hibban. This is the view of the Hanaf and Ibn Hibban in his Kitab al-Thiqat. And they gave a reasoning why they believe this. They said, لأن الناس في أحوالهم, because they said the people's situations, على الصلاح والعدالة, whether they are righteous and they are reliable and on point, حتى يتبين منهم ما يوجب الطعن. We base it upon the apparent, unless there comes a thing that removes it from the apparent. وَلَمْ يُكَلَّفِ النَّاسَ. And the people are not burdened. مَعَرِفَةُ مَا غَابَ عَنْهُمْ. To try to find out what is hidden from them. وَإِنَّمَا كُلِّفُوا. But the people are burdened to find out بِالظَّاهِرِ, that which is in the apparent. From matters. غَيْرَ الْمُغَيَّبِ عَنْهُمْ. Not from the matters which are hidden from them. That's the first point they said. The second, which is that لِأَنَّ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And they said that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam كَانَ يَعْمَلُ بِالظَّاهِرِ. That the messenger used to base things upon the apparent. وَيَتَبَرَّأُ مِنْهُ عِلْمَ الْبَاطِنِ. And he used to surrender in regards to the matters, the knowledge of the inside. He used to free himself from it and say, Allahu A'lam. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَا تَعْلَمُهُمْ. You don't know them, Muhammad. نَحْنُ نَعْلَمُهُمْ. We are the ones that know them. Meaning inside. Surah At-Tawbah, ayah 11. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the companion, Usama, he said to him, أَفَلَا شَقَقْتَ فِي قَلْبِهِ. Why haven't you opened his chest to find out what's in there? Meaning you're not going to know. Why didn't you rule him by the apparent? So they said that the riwayah of the mastur should be accepted. Nawawi took this view, and wallahu alam, Allah knows best, but it seems that the second view is the strongest. The view of the Ibn Hibban and the Ahnaf seems to be the strongest regarding the strong evidences which they have brought, and Allah knows best. The ninth criticism that came regarding al-ta'nu fi al-rawi, the criticism regarding a narrator. Na'am. We were on the ninth point of al-ta'nu fi al-rawi, the criticism that is put towards the narrator. We are on the ninth one. And it is al-bid'ah. The ninth reason why a scholar of hadith will be criticized, which is the ta'anu fi rawi, is due to what? Al-bid'ah. Innovation. Innovation. Lughatan, linguistically, what does bid'ah mean? The word bid'ah is masdar bada'a. The masdar of min bada'a. And it means ansha'a, is to initiate and to start something, to innovate something. في الأصل, it is called اختراع الشيء لا على مثال سابق. It is to innovate something without a pre-example before it. A person starts something and he has no prior example in which he took it from. يقال, it is said, ابتدع فلان بدعة. So and so has innovated. يعني ابتدع, meaning he started, he initiated, طريقةً, a path, لم يسبق إليها سابقٍ. Nothing or no one preceded him in this matter. That's what innovation means. إصطلاحاً, technically the word bid'ah means what? It means كل ما أحدث, كل ما أحدث في الدين بعد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. It is everything that is innovated, it is introduced into the religion after the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shatibi rahimahullah, he gave another definition. He said, annaha tariqah, it is a path, fi ddeen, in the religion, mukhtari'ah, which is innovated, tudahi sharia, that similes with the sharia. Yaqsudu, the person who is doing it intends, بِسُلُوكِ عَلَيْهَا, in the path in which he is taking, مَا يَقْصُدُ بِطَرِيقَةِ الشَّرْعِيَةِ, the way he intends a matter like in which he does in the sharia, meaning he tries, he wants to get closer to Allah by doing it. This definition of Shatibi doesn't seem like a very jami'ul mana. The best definition is the definition given by Imam al-Turtushi rahimahullah in his kitab Al-Hawadith wal-Bid'a. He said, it means الابتداع شامل لما تخترعه القلوب. It is anything that the hearts innovate. وتنطق به الألسنة. And anything that the tongues utter. وتفعله الجوارح. And the limbs do. It is anything that the heart initiates and innovate. And that utterance is innovated by way of utterance. And it's also uttered by ways of action. After the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. After the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam.